The following is a special presentation of Penn's TV.
Let's make sure we simplify. Get pucks to the cage, shoot that film like you have been. We gotta get in there, flood that area of the ice. Let's have dump that puck, get into spots we can go to work here. Let's be ready to go. But it's not about them, it's about us playing our game. Fast, physical, gritty hockey, detailed, smothering, tough to play against. It's wall play, it's puck retrievals, it's block shots. Every time you see a block shot, you know. Puck retrieval, you know. North centerman, we know. Right to our game, right off the hop. Sid, you ready to go? Good, because you're starting.
The build-up to a new season is always fun, and you know everyone's excited to get it going, and you know especially here with the type of team we have.
An NHL season is a roller coaster, surviving the lows and enjoying the highs.
Hey, Shelton scored!
It always begins and it always ends. The most important part is enjoying the ride. For the Pittsburgh Penguins, this season's ride began on September 16th, 2011.
A lot of excitement about our team, how good we can be. Some of that excitement is a little soon because you got 80 games, you got a lot of hockey to play.
The Penguins entered training camp with virtually the same roster as last season, leaving only a few spots open for competition.
It's tough. I definitely wouldn't want to be a coach. With the depth that we have, it's tough to mix and match, and you know, everyone deserves, you know, a chance. So it's hard to figure out, you know, who's going to make it, who's not.
Young talent would be sent down. Quality veterans wouldn't make the team. Skilled players were fighting for their jobs.
Penguins tapping the boards in response to Tang Grady's dropping of the gloves.
Typically, if you know he doesn't fight, but he steps up and you know he does something like that, everyone knows they know what he wants to win and he wants to make this team. A lot of times rosters are already set with guys you have, so the margin for error is really small.
Of all the young players with a shot to make the roster, Joe Vitale's perhaps was the longest.
It is tough to predict the opening day roster. He wasn't penciled in, and it certainly wasn't in ink, but he was in that mix of players who was going to be competing to possibly start on our opening day roster.
The roster spot under the most scrutiny, however, was the one reserved for the captain.
Sidney Crosby and his rehab, and there was an anticipation of getting him back.
Ever since I got here, it was talking about Sid, if he's coming back.
As Sidney Crosby was making his way back from a concussion, James Neal was hoping to return to form. Acquired in a trade last season, Neal brought a heavy shot, along with weighty expectations.
You know, lots of talk last year for James about not getting the goals and not coming in. And some people, I think, wondered, well, you know, he doesn't score goals. Why do we get this guy, or he's not that player? And I don't think anyone ever really thought that. He began to push and feel that pressure a little bit last year, although he was playing good hockey for our team. The quality of the team we were last year, having been a good team, made the playoffs, but what would it be like to have everybody together?
As the Penguins were eagerly awaiting that reunion, they celebrated another milestone.
Looks like to get everyone's attention here up in the front. But Dad's birthday again. The two young guys are going to sing along here.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Yes.
Happy birthday, dear Dad. Happy birthday to you.
Well, she's a vacation here.
The game of hockey rewards the hardworking. Dan Bylsma's goal was to build a team capable of working through the hardships of a season. And so, when the season began, Bylsma rewarded Joe Vitale with a sweater and a spot in the lineup.
Joe emerged as a guy with speed, with tenacity, winning faceoffs, penalty killing. Was a guy who was a factor for our team coming out of training camp, and he earned that. And then we were faced with just a potful of games starting on the West Coast.
For me, I mean, it was a fresh start, you know, a start where I could come in and be a Pittsburgh Penguin for the opening draw of the season. And, you know, for me, that was you know, very exciting.
Just 5 minutes into the season, James Neal was on the board.
Slam into the near corner to Neal, turns and shoots it, it goes in, off the goaltender Luongo, and James Neal connects. The Penguins are off and flying. Let's go, Hunt Moose on a Harley. Power play goal, James Neal.
Didn't want to put too much thought into it because then you start gripping the stick a little too much like I did last year. For me, I just want to shoot the puck. I got off to a great start with that first goal against Vancouver, and that kind of, you know, got me going.
It got the Penguins going as well. They escaped Vancouver with a win and earned 5 out of a possible 6 points in Western Canada to start the season.
It was 3 tough games, 3 home openers there with Vancouver, Calgary, and Edmonton. It was a good test for us right off the bat. We knew what kind of team we had in the room, and we knew we'd be prepared to play, and we showed that throughout the first little bit of the season.
Being on the road, you know, we just have the guys in the locker room, and you stick together, and you focus on doing the little things and trying to take the crowd out of it. And we were able to do that, I think, for the most part. To start like that is huge, and you hopefully build on that and to realize that if we play that way and we do well, we're going to win games.
It was a tough start to the season in terms of the number of games we played, where we played them, the travel that we had starting on the West Coast. And I thought our guys really showed battle and fortitude and a high level of compete from our team to win hockey games, win in tough places, win on the road.
Pittsburgh's season began by traveling over 5,000 miles in just 5 days. It was finally time for the Penguins to return home. But a sharp road trip didn't come without a price. The Penguins were winning, but injuries were mounting. Excuses, however, were not.
I think that's a part of a good team. Players are ready to step in, players are ready to come in and add and be valuable and make plays and play their role to help us be a good team when we do have guys that are injured and are out of the lineup.
The torrid pace was leaving its mark. 15 games, 9 on the road, and 9 players lost to injury. Yet Pittsburgh only lost 3 games in regulation.
Breaking Vitale going down the slot, coming towards the net, put it in front, tapped in by Cook. What a brilliant play by Joe Vitale.
You know, you talk about playing a certain way as a team, and I think our players believe in that, and it's a playing that way to a man. And when 87 or 71 or 11 is not in your lineup, you don't look at how the heck are we going to play this game. We don't have enough firepower to play against a San Jose or against an LA. We play a certain way, whether that's Sidney Crosby or Jordan Staal or Joe Vitale.
Block, and it comes right back to England to try to score. Deflected in. Right on the doorstep by Joe Vitale.
You just have to keep on going. It's part of the game, and it seems that it's happened here a lot more than maybe than other places, but the guys that step in have done a great job, and you know, I don't think we've had a time since I've been here that we've had our full lineup in, you know, for a longer period of time.
It was November in Pittsburgh. Time for Pascal Dupuis and his teammates to grow mustaches, raising awareness for men's health and chatter amongst the guys.
Hey, you look like your Halloween costume right now with that stash. Microwave?
Yeah.
No microwave.
No, microphone.
Microphone.
Yeah, you have?
Yeah. He asked me if I had a microwave.
Oh, microphone. I'd love to see what you look like right now.
You can.
No, I can't. It might not.
Cody's telling me I look like Big Show. Because he's got that mental bar going. The Big Show.
Everyone was waiting for the Big Show, Sidney Crosby's return. Could it happen against James Neal's former team, the Dallas Stars?
The 87th in your spot.
Okay. Sid's skating with you two. Playing wing?
I don't know what's going on.
Yeah. Sid's practicing with you guys. You too. I love it.
As the speculation mounted, so did the questions from Crosby's teammates.
What are you doing? Thanks, that's awesome.
Things were returning to normal. Crosby's return was imminent. And so was some embarrassment for whoever lost the latest shootout to end practice.
Hawaiian shirt here?
Hawaiian shirt week. You lose the shootout, you gotta wear a Hawaiian shirt for a week.
The Hawaiian shirt with the stash is gonna be sick. That is bold that he can't do that. He's so athletic. I gotta. Your glove up!
Look at him with the leg kick you off.
On either! Dallas in town too, perfect.
Oh my God.
I can't believe!
This stick's a joke, man.
Good job, Neither. It's a good stick, you just didn't get lucky. It looks sick, though. Tomorrow, your boy's gonna laugh at you.
The stars came and went, and so did another game without number 87. For a lineup in constant flux, James Neal remained the constant.
James Neal haunts his old team and scores.
After recording just one goal for the Penguins last year, he scored twice against his former team and recorded points in 15 of the first 18 games this season.
He's really jumped to the forefront of the league in goals, obviously, and that's been a big thing for him. And I really do think getting that puck to go in Vancouver was a big step for him.
18 games into the season, and the Penguins were alone atop the Eastern Conference. But they did have some company on their two-game road trip to Florida.
It was my first dad's trip, so it was good to have my father come with me on the road and see what I do on a daily basis. He helped me growing up, and I wouldn't be in this position if it wasn't for him. So it was very, very nice to have him around.
If it weren't for the father-son bonding time, the trip would have been forgettable, as the Penguins lost to both Tampa Bay and Florida.
So many emotions, when you play. You know, you're going to have spots, I mean, as a team and individually, where you're not doing that well. You just have to make sure that you keep them in check. You're not getting too excited with each win and too down after each low.
Players anticipate the ebb and flow of the season. So as they sent their fathers home, they welcomed back another member of the family.
Sid, you ready to go? Good, because you're starting. We are going with 44. 58, 14, 9, 87, and Flower, you're in the cage here, gentlemen. Let's go, let's go.
Come on, boys, let's go, let's go, boys. Come on, Ashley, come on, boys. Come on, man, come on, man.
It had been a long journey, 319 days since Sidney Crosby had last played a game. The wait was finally over.
I knew the drama part was going to be there. I knew that the fans were going to be at a different level. Tough to draw up what happens on the ice.
Dupuis to Crosby. Darts into the Islanders end, goes to the net. Hey! Shelton scores with a gorgeous backhander. And the Penguins take a 1-0 lead. Oh, slap me silly, Sidney.
You expect him to have a flair for the dramatic. You expect that he stepped up in those situations in a lot of games before, a lot of special games, but that was a pretty dramatic highlight in a dramatic fashion from Sidney Crosby and punctuated by the celebration in the corner.
You see how much Pittsburgh loves him and how much the fans love him, and it was cool to be a part of it, and obviously my first time playing alongside Sid, so it was a lot of fun.
The captain was back, where he belongs, on the ice. His playground. All of Pittsburgh was having fun.
Crosby darts in to get it. Goes to his knees as he's hit. But he keeps on going. Your senior's on it. Chases him all over the ice. Crosby wheel and deal. Throw it to the net. It's in the goal. Oh, great balls of fire. He beats your senior, turn him inside out and put him on the parkway.
And an outpouring of love and appreciation for the captain of the Penguins and the greatest player in the game, who once again proved his greatness here tonight. 4-point night for Sid.
I mean, I thought he'd get a hat trick, so no, he came back and did great. You know, the way he plays on the ice and what he does with the puck and how fast he moves, it's pretty impressive. He's a special player, and he couldn't have had a better night.
I had a pretty good idea that the first star in the game before the game was started was going to be Sidney Crosby.
The first star of the game, number 87, Sidney Crosby!
The ups and downs of the season are just beginning. Navigating the speed bumps and pushing forward are what define a team. Luckily for the Penguins, their captain is back and now along for the ride.
This has been a presentation of Pens TV.